Man's desire has always been simple, to be happy. The process by which to achieve happiness is what has proven to be difficult. Since childhood, our concept of happiness has been shaped by society, and in an age of consumerism, we are constantly bombarded with images, advertisements, told to buy miracle drugs, flash cars, expensive washing machines. The list goes on, all promising lasting happiness. Enough is never enough.
Through an increasing number of manipulative channels, people are constantly told what to think, how to perceive the world, and what ultimately to consider as reality and happiness.
Through television, the world is bombarded with images of sex, violence, and cruelty. Invariably, such graphic images have psychological effects on adults and children alike. Music, which has the power to invoke passionate emotions, is another powerful instrument. Offensive and negative lyrics have an intense effect on the thought process, invoking sexual and material desires.
With the advent of these new forms of so-called home entertainment, more and more people are becoming brain dead. We are constantly being brainwashed, to the extent that we don't even feel the need to think or question our actions, but simply follow the norm.
Sex, drugs, and rock and roll has been the theme for the last 50 years. The number of juveniles taking alcohol and drugs is on the increase, as is the number of children experimenting at an even younger age.
Or resorting to seek altered states of consciousness through artificial means. Both legal and illegal drugs have become the painkillers of the world, numbing the profound psychological depression experienced by many. Drugs are a drain not only on the physical body, but also on the mind, making it vulnerable to all kinds of manipulation. Addiction offers a very powerful way to enslave people to passions and to their lower natures. Most violent crimes in the Western world are drugs or alcohol related.
The drug culture has diseased our world as an artificial way of stimulating consciousness, anesthetizing the pain, or filling the emptiness that pervades people's lives. The quick fix. The desire for sexual fulfillment runs deep within society and the individual. It forms the basis of most intimate relationships. But the desire for sexual pleasure without restriction has now become so accepted that a person who does not engage in free sex is considered to be repressed. Sex grips the world like no other single activity.
...84% of American girls and 88% of American boys have had sexual relations by the age of 20. 21% of them have had sex even before the age of 15. More than one-third of children born out of wedlock are born to teenagers.
Abortion rates are rising dramatically. Abortion has become a popular contraceptive device carried out on demand. Just another method used to counteract lack of responsibility for sexual behavior. Today, millions kill their own seed. Over 40 to 60 million abortions are performed each year. One out of every three pregnancies are aborted. The practice of abortion derives in no small part from the belief that no God or soul exists, and that the fetus is not yet a human being.
...66% of marriage partners have been unfaithful at some point in their lives in the USA. No wonder that 50% of marriages result in divorce. Sexually transmitted diseases are amongst the greatest threat to humanity. One in 250 adults is now HIV positive. 5,000 newly infected each day.
In 1991, more than 106,000 rapes occurred in the United States, which means more than 300 rapes took place every day, 12 rapes every hour, and only one rape in six is ever reported. At that rate, more than 12 million women have been raped between a 20-year period of 1972 to 1991. One in six of all these victims is a child. All these figures are on the increase.
It is not difficult to understand why sexual promiscuity and deviancy are on the increase. Sex sells. The biggest business on the net is pornography. At every turn, programs and advertisements in the media contain sexual overtones, providing relentless sexual stimulation. Pornography has become one of the world's most profitable industries, with so many countries spending billions upon it. The internet is growing rapidly. Access for a child is simple.
Inasmuch as this is a time when there are practically no bars to sexual activity, it may come as no surprise to hear accounts of animalistic behavior, acting instinctively according to whatever feels good, regardless of the consequences.
Everyone is looking for happiness. Sex, intoxication, and drugs are just a few of the predominant ways in which people search for it.
However, as the world moves in leaps and bounds towards greater material advancement, in its attempt to make the world a happier and better place to live, people are still becoming more and more unsatisfied with their way of life.
The second largest industry in the world is the pharmaceutical drugs industry. The highest selling drug in the West are antidepressants. The World Health Organization has predicted that in 10 years' time, the biggest killer will be mental illnesses such as depression, taking over diseases such as cancer and heart disease.
So try it. Go ahead. Try it all. See if all these wonderful material luxuries we have at our disposal can make you happy.
But in your quest for happiness, why not try spiritual life too? You never know. You might experience a different perspective on reality. One that is blissful and not so temporary in nature.